How are you doing today?
Just fine. How are you?
Good. What did you bring in for us here?
I brought you the Sword of Perryville. This was found in the Karrick-Parks House in Perryville in 2011 by Vicki Goode, who's the Main Street Perryville director, when she was cleaning the house to get ready for a quilt show that they were going to put on in the Karrick-Parks House. And she was cleaning underneath the stairs, and she found this. And it had been hidden, we figure, since the Battle of Perryville, which was October 8th, 1862. And everybody was shocked when it was found because the house had been continuously occupied by the same family until the 1990s. And nobody had ever found it. It was safely hidden.
Well, that's an incredible story. I'm a kind of a history buff about Perryville, the battle.
Oh, cool.
And I think it's unique because that's one of the original standing houses that was there during the war. And what we have in here today is a unique sword bayonet. And this fits on a muzzle of a gun. And this is a super rare version. This particular bayonet was made in New Orleans.
Cool.
And it was made by a very well... interesting jeweler that combined with a swordsmith, and they called themselves Cookin' Brothers. This is a Cookin' Brother sword bayonet, and it is not marked. It's distinctive style, the ribs here on the grip, and this is a copy of a model 1858 Enfield made in Britain, and so they copied that pattern, and the grip is more petite, real unique guard, and this is to protect the user in case somebody swung a sword at him or a bayonet. It's missing the scabbard. The piece here is a throat for the scabbard, and that is not made by Cookin' Brothers. That's an Enfield, which is not uncommon because the leather scabbards didn't last long in the field, and so it would interchange with an Enfield. Mm-hmm. It's very unique that it's on there. It's great. These things are super rare. I can't tell you how rare they are. The blades are hand-hammered. And again, part of the team of the Cook Brothers was a jeweler, and this is made from a wax cast mold, not a sand cast, and it's really super rare.
Wonderful.
And have you ever had it appraised or any value put to it?
It hasn't been appraised.
Okay. Well, this particular sword bayonet would value around $1,500 to $2,000, but with the history of Perryville, and anything that's battle related that you can actually prove was in a battle, which this is, adds a significant amount to it. So it would probably be between the value of $2,500 to $3,000.
Wow, that's great. The people of Perryville will be very proud.
Well, good. That's thank great. You for bringing it in.
Well, thank you for telling us about
okay.
it. Okay, great.